Good afternoon, everybody. It's time for your studio painting update and daily ramble number 22. Yes, we're getting up there in our numbers. Sorry about yesterday. I didn't have time to do any rambling at all or show you my progress. I posted a picture of it up after the initial blocking. And basically today I've just worked upon more of that. Didn't have much time to paint. I only had about 2 hours of studio time today. But I'm quite pleased with where I've got to. I had a few challenges along the way. There's always adjustments to, fine-tuning shapes and things like that, so I did a little bit of that. But I had some challenges with the colour of the persimmon. They're orange, but they're a different sort of orange, and they're a yellow, but they're a different sort of yellow. And so I really kind of played with the colour and kept pushing the colour around a little bit. I found with my orange that I did come up with a solution for it, and I'll swing it round, we can have a look. Hopefully it's all nicely squared up for you, and you see the whole painting. I'm trying to get better at this, trying to get better at my production, so you see what I'm talking about and not just half the painting, as of one of the comments in this, one of the videos, that they couldn't see the whole painting. I think it's when I did the demonstration one, they're only seeing the top half. So I'm swinging around now and let's see if we can see the whole painting. Well, I can see the whole painting in the phone now, so hopefully when this comes up on Facebook they don't chop off the bottom of it or anything like that. So that's where I got to today. You can see there's a lot more weight of paint on there, particularly the dark paint. I've used that, put a lot of body in the dark paint, especially against my light objects here, to make those light objects look brighter, and also using the background to cut in and correct shapes. And that's important, not just work on the positive form, but we call this negative space. And so in order for this to be right, these negative spaces also have to be right. So each are independent of one, each are dependent on one another. So as you can see, I'm kind of building up the persimmon. I've still got another, I'll pass over them one more time and build them up. But this little poor guy down here, he was my guinea pig persimmon. And what I like to do is solve all my colour problems and my tone problems just on one at first and see if it works. And when I find something that works, I'll introduce it to the rest. But having worked on this a few times and to get it right, it started to grow. And that's something to watch out for. I wasn't keeping my eye on the proportion and also my eye on this area, the negative area. So once I realized, okay, it's getting a little bit big, I went back and did some measurement, and sure enough, it had grown. So it's just had a major trim, and I've wiped back again just to let the glow of the canvas do its work, to give me that brighter tone. And I'll go back in there first thing tomorrow and finish him off. But the tones and colours I found in this have worked gorgeously for these. As you can see, I've still got a little bit of blending to do. I've got to find some soft quarter tones between here and here. I had them on my palette, I just didn't get time to do it today. More shadows and twigs. I'm happy with how these shadows and twigs here are coming up. They need a little bit more definition, but they're coming up nice and strong. And the colour, I want to talk about colour. For these, they're kind of, when you look at the persimmons, they're kind of orange, but they're not quite orange. And they're kind of yellow, but they're not quite yellow. It's a very translucent sort of skin to the persimmon. And so I wanted to get that translucency. Now, orange is easy to make, of course, with cad red and cad yellow, but both of those being opaque paints, I wasn't getting that transparency that I was looking for. So what I decided to do was to mix the cad yellow with alizarin crimson. And that's where you see this gorgeous orange here. And it just glows with the more opaques around it. It gives you that sensation of translucency. And I just keep introducing a little bit more as I go pass over them. You see it's introduced beautifully here. Some of them are kind of more orangey and some of the persimmons are more yellowy. So, but it's still, I'm still introducing bits of it here and there just to make them work. And tomorrow, this paint would have tacked off and it will be ready for a nice fresh layer of more paint over the top of it tomorrow. So I'm looking forward to coming in tomorrow. Hopefully no interruptions and I can get more of it done. I haven't done anything at all to the vessel here, of the comport. That can wait, and I just want to get these done first. And if I get these right, it'll help me get this right as well. But I am keeping my eye on this as I paint in these darker little areas and the areas between, that it's in line with the ellipse. You know, so that's very important. I don't want to have to go and adjust that later on. I'm looking forward to doing the reflections, and the surface has this nice greyishness about it. It's a dark grey, but there's this nice cool grey coming over the top. I'm looking forward to doing that. And then the rest of the background here is a bit of a cancel out. Darkest here, lightest across here, but it's also got every now and then these breaks in it of a nice kind of metallic-y colour. This material is, it's a piece of material that you're looking at, what I'm painting, has a bit of a shot sheen to it. So I'll be introduced, it'll be broken up a little bit, it won't be all just one colour graduating to another tone. There'll be little introductions of colour there. So that's where we're up to. I hope you are enjoying it. I'm quite happy with where it's going, and it looks good when it's turned around in its proper position and the light's on it again. But there you have it. That's where I'm up to, and back to me. So I hope you found that interesting, and I hope you found it valuable for information. And if you think this is worthy and other people might like to see it, give it a share. Make sure you give it a like. And if you're not following me already, please follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. I'm slowly but surely uploading them to YouTube. And but they are there. I've got quite a big audience at YouTube. So hopefully I start attracting some views on YouTube as well. And if you feel so inclined, please pop a comment below. Love reading them. And they help me do this better. And I'm trying to get my production better each time. And they also interest me, and they interest others. And they help with the algorithms, and it helps Facebook get this out to even more people. So have a great evening, and I shall see you again, hopefully, tomorrow. Cheers.